First off, quite a different public face that you're putting on from a year ago. Who would have guessed that you would be supporting the repeal on Don't Ask, Don't Tell if, say, we were a year ago?
I guess I'm as surprised as anyone, but these things have happened in my life, and I am now all about saying what I mean very truthfully and openly. And when it comes to this particular subject of gay people being discriminated against, either in the military or being allowed to join, this is a policy our nation should end. We should never be about discrimination. We should never be about big government prying into the private lives of our citizens. Mm-hmm. And these are core conservative Republican values.
Okay. Hey, Mr. Ashburn, I'm sure folks out there have called you things like a hypocrite. Do you think this is something you're just going to have to work to change?
I've been called a lot of things. And if that word fits, the fact that I did cast votes that I'm not proud of because I was trying to hide my secret, I regret it deeply. So whatever word people want to ascribe to that, I can certainly understand.
Certainly. All right, so we do have some Facebook questions for you this morning. The first one comes in from Patty Pfister in Kern County, and she asks, is he, meaning yourself, going to represent those that voted him into office, or is he going to begin pushing his own personal agenda? Your response, Senator.
My first concern will always be the best interests of the people in our state and in our nation, and certainly to represent the people who have been very, very kind to me and have granted me the privilege of representing them in the state legislature.
All right, another question now, this one from Arvin Florney. He says, quote, what does he plan to do to remedy the situation since his votes damaged initiatives to expand basic human rights to people of the LGBT community?
I think that's a great question. I did cast votes that deprived individuals of basic rights, equal treatment under the law. That's called discrimination. I'm not proud of those votes. I cast those votes not even looking at, in some instances, the content of the bills because I was more concerned about concealing my secret. I regret that very deeply. I will not behave in that manner going forward during the remainder of my time in the legislature, which, by the way, ends in the first week in December.
Well, okay, moving on now to a different topic altogether. We also want to talk about the state budget. We have seen the May revisions. There are discussions going on right now on how to deal with this massive deficit. Can you give us any updates?
Well, the legislature is plodding along, holding the budget hearings, hearing from people about the specific impacts. The picture's not good. The bottom line is that the state budget reflects the health, or in this case, the illness of our economy here in California. This is a very tough climate for job creation and for businesses that provide those jobs. It's no surprise that with fewer people working, we have less tax revenue to pay the bills to provide the services that people want. And yet, the majority party in Sacramento, very frustratingly, will not address job creation. The regulations, the tax burdens, this inhospitable jobs climate in California continues to go on. And this is an emergency condition that both parties ought to be able to come together on. And let's do those things to ease the burden on the job creators in our state so that we can put people back to work. That's the solution to the budget problem. In the meantime, we've got some tough choices ahead. Real cuts are going to have to be made. And I just think that after what took place in February of last year with the big tax increases, no more taxes. Public cannot take more obligation and more financial burden.
All right. Senator Roy Ashburn, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For your thoughts on that and other topics as well. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.